sport is a great opportunity for students, I think. It's a chance for them to get a lot of hands-on experience that they wouldn't get in a classroom. And for me, it's an outlet to play with cars.
Formula SAE is a collegiate competition that's sponsored by the Society of Automotive Engineers.
The competition was actually started at UT by Dr. Matthews in 1981.
The very first competition, there were six schools who said they would come, only four did come. Now there are 140 that register for it, so it's huge.
From the beginning through the end, all the way to machining little cone inserts to center bolts in holes, everything is done by the students.
They have to find the money, they have to find the supplies, they have to learn how to use the supplies, learn how to machine, learn how to weld, we have to buy the tools, we have to do everything. There are some schools where the faculty advisor designs most of the car and specs out the parts. So the benefit we have here is that we're actually totally in charge of the project and we're getting the most educational benefit out of it we can.
In the first year of the competition, we won the award for best appearance and we won the award for engineering creativity, but we did lose a wheel, and so that obviously hurt us.
When it comes to parts, we like to buy as much as we can because it's very time intensive to build anything. But unfortunately, most parts are designed for full-size cars and we can't use very many of them. Probably only 20% of the parts on the car are bought and not majorly modified.
When we first started Formula SAE, we didn't have the engineering tools available for the students' use that we have now. And by that I mean we didn't have all the computer-aided engineering, computer-aided graphics. We didn't have all the sophisticated instrumentation and test equipment that we have now. And so I think teams that are involved in Formula SAE now have a real benefit in being able to design more sophisticated cars.
The great thing about Formula SAE is that the cars are designed according to rules that force it to be a safe car. You can take the Formula car out and you can drive like a real jerk and you can not really get into trouble. It's a lot of fun to take it out and really throw it around the course. The hard part is remembering when you get in your car that you can't do that anymore.
The competition takes place in Detroit in May. We're judged on dynamic tests. We have endurance, we have autocross, we have acceleration and skid pad. So that measures the performance of our car. And we also have static events where we have to explain the design of the car, we have to justify all the costs, we have to sell our car. So it's basically a total engineering package where we have to sell and do everything ourselves.
The most challenging thing or difficult thing for me was going to the design presentation because the design judges are engineers at the automotive companies and so they've got a lot of experience and so they can point out a dozen flaws in your car in about 30 seconds and you've spent an entire year building this car. It's kind of hard to hear because they'll just tear all your work down pretty quick, but it's important that you listen to them.
The auto companies are quite impressed with the students who take part in this competition. In fact, use this competition as a technique for recruiting students, recruiting new engineers, co-op students, and summer interns.
The rules state that if you want to go to competition, you have to be a student, but there's no requirement on being an engineering major or any kind of major like that. We've had business students, we've had high school interns come around. We could always use anybody's help.
There's nothing like a huge project like this, one that can span several years even, to force you to come out of your shell, and you have to get really involved in every aspect.
At UT, I was going to get a good education, but I was only going to be able to read from the textbooks. Whereas here, I can actually build things, I can learn how to weld, I can learn how to machine, and I can get a sense of what all my classes are aiming for.
It's the world's largest intercollegiate student engineering design competition, and we started it right here.